Hey guys, how's it going? Apparently Nightmare Fuel had done a video about me and I didn't notice it because he didn't tweet it at me, but to be honest, I didn't tweet my other video at him, even though it wasn't really a response to him. I just mentioned his video for like a minute or two in this long thing. None of my followers tweeted it at me or anything, even though one particular subscriber of mine mentioned that he would love to see a fight between me and him and didn't bother to mention that he made a video. And I don't subscribe to his channel because it's fucking trash, but that's another point. So the first few things before we get started, before anything, is one, I was not offended. He likes to say that I'm offended because it makes me sound like I'm more re when I'm not. I'm not re. I don't find anti-theism offensive, just like I don't find Kevin Logan offensive. I just find him ridiculous and stupid. I'm not interested in any kind of religious apologetics at all, Christian or Islam. They're both vile to me. And the only religion I find beneficial is Satanism, which leads me to my last point, is that I'm not trying to virtue signal to Christians by saying, hey guys, I'm a good atheist, as a Satanist. I mean, such a claim is just so absurd on its face. Or perhaps maybe he thought that my kind of use of satanic imagery and the fact that I mentioned that I'm a Satanist in my Twitter bio, which this is the what it really boils down to, is he's offended by my Twitter thread. You know, like he didn't bother to click it and to find out, like, oh, this dude's a Satanist. That would really kind of throw a fork in that, or stick in that spoke, I guess. Now, there's two big problems that Nightmare Fuel does throughout this entire video. The first one is that he makes like these absolute claims, right? That anti-theists don't do this. Anti-theists do this. They don't say this. They don't do that. They don't believe this. And they don't believe that. But interwoven within that, he makes it very clear, of course, there's exceptions to the rule. Of course, you could find like someone like Christopher Cantwell, who's an anti-theist, who believes in insane, bigoted things, of course. But generally speaking, the majority of them do not. And now this is a sort of thing that an intellectual charitability that I exercise with people that I debate. Of course, I know when they talk in terms of absolutes, they're not there. Of course, there's exceptions to every rule. Of course, I understand that. And I'm very charitable in that realm. But he doesn't extend that same kind of charity back to me. In fact, he even goes a step further, even when I explicitly say not all. Not all, he'll still imply that I'm saying all, and then attack that as like that's ridiculous that he believes that. It's absurd. Of course, when I'm doing this, I'm either being completely hyperbolic when I'm stating positions of other people, and then other times I'm very clear. So I think it's very clear when I'm talking about these things that I'm not being like I'm doing the exact same thing that he does, where he's making absolute claims, but it's very clear that I'm not, that I'm, you know, that there's a little bit of extra oomph to it by saying that all things are this way, or most things are, or the vast majority of things are this way. You know what I'm trying to say. And I know what he's trying to say when he says these things. He doesn't have to mention that. I just assume that that's what he means. The other thing that he does is he also will take like a claim that I make, right? Also, I'll say claim A, and then what he does is he'll ascribe this to like a certain set of behaviors, because a certain set of behaviors or a certain group or a school of thought may include one of these claims, right? And then say, and then bridge that gap and say, well, this is what Jim is. So he's saying, he's pointing out other kinds of terrorism, right? Besides Islam. So there, and the other types of people that do that are Islamic apologists or whataboutists. So therefore, Jim must be a whataboutist, and he also must be an Islamic no, but that's not what I was getting at. That's not the point I'm trying to make. I don't share the same ideas as Islamic apologists, nor am I engaging in about what is whataboutism, just because that's one particular component in whataboutism. That's not what I'm trying to do. I'm not trying to do whataboutism. Now, if I were to do the same thing to him, he would be very upset and call me a straw manner and say that I'm lying and whatever. And that is to say, when he says something along the lines of going to war over resources is far more rational than a holy war, that would be like me saying, well, he must be for the Iraq war because that was based on oil. It's absurd, right? But that's what he's constantly doing throughout this entire video, right? He's ignoring the point that I'm trying to make, which is that if you get rid of religious reasons for people doing bad things, they're going to find secular versions for doing that. There's going to be an intellectual vacuum for this. And it's very clear that that's the point that I'm trying to make in this Twitter thread. And it's completely glossed over by him. He just doesn't even mention that that's the point I'm trying to make. So let's get into this thing right off the bat. So first tweet that I made, or in this hit list, is that Nightmare Fuel says that anti-theists don't bigotry because anti-theists judge people based on their ideas. So if they have a bad idea, they judge them poorly. If they have a good idea, then they judge them positively. This is a priori like false. It's like saying I'm not a bachelor because I'm not married. It's wrong before we even have to look at the evidence. Just by understanding what those words mean, it's false. Bigotry is, one of the definitions of bigotry is intolerance of any creed, belief, or opinion that differs from one's own. Anyways, number two, a better world. Now, when I say that anti-theists believe X, that doesn't mean that I think that that's the only thing that's true in that realm. For example, when I say that the anti-theists believe that, you know, one of the major problems in the world is religion, that doesn't necessarily follow that I mean that all of the world's problems have everything to do with religion. If we just got rid of that, there would be no room for any other problems. Of course, I don't believe that or believe that that's what they necessarily believe. I know that they believe that that's the primary reason why. And that's the issue that I take with anti-theism, because I don't believe that that's the main reason why. That's the issue that we're having right now, right? but he knows. I think he really knows this. I think he's intentionally being obtuse. Okay, so I'm not just going to pick on communists, right? I'm not letting them off the hook either, for fuck's sake. But they're a good example of what I will use from here on out. Is that communists are anti-theists? Well, hold on. I gotta clarify. There are some exceptions. There are Christian atheists or Christian communists. All right, I get it. Okay, I have to say that because I'm not afforded the luxury of talking in absolutes when I fully accept exceptions. But these communist groups not only have anti-theistic positions, they also have a totalitarian and violent one. These communist groups have they want to install a violent, tyrannical state that seeks to implement these ideas, and they often do so through acts of terrorism. Now, if you were to convert every Christian to atheism and every Muslim to atheism, do you think that these groups would have an ideological vacuum that they could feed off of and gain more support off of? Of course they will. Of course they will, which is the point that I was trying to make that you completely gloss over. Again, if you get rid of the reasons for people being shitty, if you get rid of one reason they could be shitty, they'll find another reason to be shitty, because that's what shitty people do. They're shitty. Number three, there are wars fought over religious reasons. Name one. I pointed out in that thread that every single one of these holy wars that people keep pointing to as examples of the reasons why religions are terrible, because they start wars, and if we just got rid of religion, there'd be far less wars. I didn't say no more war. I'd say there'd be far less wars. That's what I believe they believe, and that's what they believe. If you get rid of the religious reasons for it, they're just going to find another reason to engage in this war and just not put them in religious fervor. There's two examples, like, and I said that, and he says, like, oh, but yeah, there are holy wars. Then name one. You didn't name one in your video. Like, this is the second time you've heard me talk about this thing, and you still can't name a single goddamn holy war that doesn't have secular reasonings for it. The two that I keep getting often, not from you because you're too chicken shit to name one. The two that I keep getting is the jihad from Al Qaeda, and then the religious crusades. The Al Qaeda fatwa lines out in that fatwa what the reasons are. And most of it is religious, to be fair. It's most of it is very religious. But the reasons for that war were mostly limited, were mostly confined to a few things that were not religious. That is, the U.S.'s involvement in the Middle East, military involvement in the Middle East, then their meddling, their continued support of Israel, and the existence of Israel over the land that they see as theirs, that was taken away from them in the 40s. That's what their problem is, right? And if they can get support by coaxing it in religious support, they're going to do it. If everybody stops being a Muslim tomorrow and they all start deciding like, hey, maybe we should start looking up at this I don't know, whatever ideology, the secular ideology, they're going to find secular reasons for doing so. That has been the case throughout time. Anytime that a nation becomes a little bit more secular, they start finding less secular reasons for engaging in violent behavior. It's always been the case, which is the point that I've been making this whole time and just keep glossing over. The other one was the Crusades. Now, the Crusades were, again, about trying to preserve, quote unquote, holy lands and preventing another group, another nation, from invading those lands and taking it over. And the papacy, which is basically a government at the time, did not want that to happen. They wanted to have dominance over that particular tribe of area. And so they said, hey, look, Christians, they're trying to take over your holy land. You better come and fight for it. This has been the case over and over and over and over again, that these people have very material, very secular goals, and they use religion as a means to achieve those goals. Or they'll try to, to rationalize their violent behavior for those reasons. And if you take away that reason, they're going to find another reason, okay? The USSR did not have to find any religious reasons whatsoever to go to war with other countries or to take over other countries. They just fucking took them, and they used secular reasons for doing it. Now, you say that you know, if you have war for resources, that's far more rational. Okay, how is that any better? To go to war over a country, to go to war with a country, and presuming that tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, millions of tens of millions, whatever, however big the war is going to be, people killed, both combatants and non-combatants alike, innocent civilians, collateral damage, infrastructure destroyed, just because you want some oil. How is that any better when you're saying, well, at least it wasn't over a sky daddy? Give me a fucking break. Number four, bigotry. Again, he says that, like, no one ever said there would be no bigotry if anti-theists got their way, which is why I specifically used the word less, not none, in that tweet. I said that that anti-theists believe that there would be less bigotry, sexism, and racism, and whatever. Not there would be no bigotry, sexism, racism, right? I mean, you fucking read it out loud. God damn it. As mentioned before, secularisms, or I don't think I mentioned this yet. Sorry, I've done another take of this, apparently. Secularism does have divine rights. I don't see how you can completely ignore this just because it's not specifically divine. They still have irrational reasons for doing things that are coaxed in very quote unquote reasonable light. For example, science is a great example. Do I doubt that global warming is happening and that man cause is probably the most likely cause? I believe that. That's true. Does that necessarily mean that I'm denying that fact when I say that the government's attempts to curb it by carbon credits and investing in green technology will have any impact on it whatsoever? Of course, it doesn't have any impact on it. There's no evidence that it does have this sort of impact on it. But if you pull it out, it's people try to bring out these other kind of things and saying, like, well, you just don't believe in the science of global warming. You know, you're one of these religious people who believe that God has a plan for everything, you know, because the last name in your nickname is Jesus. I keep seeing this over and over again. It's completely absurd. Another thing, which I'm not going to subscribe whether or not it's true, but you can have scientific reasons to be completely shitty. And it could be true or not, whatever. And that is like, look at all these studies with IQ links between certain races of people and high IQs and low IQs, and all the links between populations that have low IQ and how they correlate with crime and poverty, etc. And people use this as a justification to be shitty to black people, right? Does it really matter if there are reasons for treating people poorly, unjustifiably, poorly, depended completely on like the scientific God, you know, quote unquote God, you know, we're like, oh, look, the science says that this is true, therefore we can treat people like shit because they're subhuman? Or does it really matter if the sky daddy told me I could? It doesn't matter. You're still end up with the same results, right? People will find secular reasons to be shitty to other people, period. Now, by the way, I need to mention that I don't believe that Nightmare Fuel thinks that black people should be treated differently than other people. But I'm just trying to show you that just getting rid of one spooky religion, spooky thing, does not necessarily imply that there won't be other spooks to come around and take its place. Number five, irrationality. Now, I mentioned a few things, and I specifically mentioned these ones because these are the ones that I see anti-theists constantly supporting. Every time I see this, I see anti-theists and then they also start talking about these particular topics, right? And that's like secular spirituality, right? Or animal rights, environmentalism, anti-GMO stuff, anti-Monsanto stuff, Marxism. And he says in this video, like, he's like, do you think the average anti-theist takes issues with these ideas? No, they don't. The average anti-theist probably adheres to at least one of these, if not more, if not all. I mean, sure, like maybe your little circle of anti-theists don't, but for the most part, anti-theists on at least hold to at least one of these kind of crazy ideas. I'm glad that you don't. Good for you. Good for you. But for the most part, they do. Number six, terror. Okay. So this was never about Whataboutery. I was never trying to point out that, look, you know, the Tamil Tigers existed. Therefore, you know, they were secular. Therefore, we can just completely not have to worry about Islamic terror. Like, no. And I'm not engaging in Islamic, apologetics as well. No, I think it's terrible. I think it's all terrible. I do. But you can't say that once the religion goes away, that those shitty people are going to stop being shitty and all of a sudden be good to everybody and hold hands and sing kumbaya. Okay? That's hyperbole. I have to fucking be careful, okay? That they're going to be less shitty. How about that? That's a completely absurd statement. It's completely absurd. The point that I was trying to make is that these regions don't necessarily have that kind of characteristic of believing in this religion. So what do? They find other reasons to be violent and commit acts of terror. In one particular case, it may be communism. There's a lot of communist terrorist groups that go around and they commit acts of terror, right? Sure, they're not as common as Islam. It's by leaps or bounds. But guess what happens when you get rid of Islam? They're going to find something else to be violent over. It's just the fucking case. And you can see it over and over and over and over again. And all Al-Qaeda will do is stop wrapping their stuff. Al-Qaeda is not too much around anymore. But groups like ISIS and Al-Qaeda are going to wrap their kind of ideology in some other flavor. I mean, ISIS, great example, ISIS. ISIS really was not about religion so much as it was trying to get domination over a land where there was a power vacuum. That's what it was. They were training a state and they could get support by coaxing it in religious fervor. That's what they did. And they also knew that they could achieve their goals by people committing jihad or committing acts of terror. And so they did. You have to be fucking stupid. You have to be fucking stupid to think that these groups of people are just going to all of a sudden not be so violent anymore once they give up their sky daddy, or that being rational for the reasons for being a sky daddy. Well, it's not for a sky daddy. It's because this group of people are capitalists, and these capitalist groups you know, exploit their workers, and we can use, you know, arguments from first principles in order to show that, you know, that this is a bad thing and we need to go and help them. It doesn't fucking matter. You're still doing something absolutely fucking horrid, even if it is quote unquote rational or more rational. Now, number seven is cult. This is the part where I know that he's being intellectually dishonest, like intentionally obtuse. So Nightmare Fuel asserts that I think that everything is a cult because I said China's a cult. And there's two things in those tweets that are a dead giveaway that I don't believe this to be true. One is that I use a very specific term that I'm pretty sure he's never heard of before, which is high demand group. Another one I talk about using a very specific criteria, and I use the term, I think I said cult criteria models. So apparently that there's some sort of criteria that I have to put things to in order to verify whether or not they're a cult. If I believe that everything is a cult, I wouldn't need a fucking criteria, would I, Nightmare Fuel? But I'm the idiot, right? So no, I'm talking about cults as a high demand group, okay? Which has a very specific criteria, which I mentioned and you've noted, you even read it aloud. And these criteria include milieu control, mystical manipulation, the demand for purity, cult of confession, sacred science, loading of the language, doctored over person, and the dispensing of existence. And they're using those to abuse their adherents for the benefit of a group of people or one particular person at the top of an organization. That's what a high demand group is, according to people who are experts in this field. And the people who are experts in this field all usually use a book as a starting reference. It's one of the first books on thought reform, or what you would probably call brainwashing, that's very important into this line of psychology, cult psychology, which is Dr. Robert Lifton's book, which, by the way, I'm going to post a link to this in the description. I'll make a note of that now. Thought Reform and the Psychology of Totalism, a Study of Brainwashing in China. This book came out because United States Air Force psychologist was sent on a mission to go find out what the heck was going on in China, because they were producing basically brainwashed zombies. And he went to go figure out what the hell was going on. And he came out with this book and he showed what these are. He also studied some other totalist states that were doing similar things and came back and said that this was happening. After he released the book, a lot of ex-cult members started coming out saying, that's what happened to me inside the Moonies. That's what happened to me inside of Scientology. And then people started using that as a reference to kind of understand how cults operate in the United States. Now, it's important to mention the fact that he went to China to figure this out, and that virtually every cult leader cult expert leaders, in the country use this as a reference and points out that China is the biggest cult in the world. And they would not apply this to various other states. They would not. Not in terms of what they're using for this specific definition. So, again, this is what he's also doing again. Is he's saying, well, this person says claim A, and that there's another guy on the internet that I've never fucking heard of, who sounds like a complete kook, says that, you know, China is a cult. And he also says that everything's a cult. So, therefore, he must believe the same thing that this guy does. It's so fucking stupid. Like, I can't wrap my mind around it's hard for me to accept that he's not being intentionally obtuse. Like, he knows that it's bullshit, but he's just saying it anyway because it makes him feel like he's getting one hand over me, and that his fans are not even going to bother to take the time to even understand what the point of what I was trying to say. Because let's face it, like, YouTube people, sorry, a lot of you are dumb. A lot of you are really fucking dumb, and I see this over and over again, and that's why. But the cream doesn't rise to the top. You know, it's a swamp, and the scum does. Sorry, this is just absolutely true. My audience knows I love them though, because I weeded all the bad ones out. That's what happened. China's a cult. Now, he also says that, like, name one anti-theist who believes this. Lots of anti-theists believe that if you got rid of religion, then cults will almost be a thing of the past. Now, I did, again, talk in absolutist terms, but granted that I'm being very charitable with your absolutist claims, you could probably be a little bit more charitable with mine as well. Of course, I don't believe that sure, there would probably be five or six cults that are still around hanging out even after the end of all religions that are religious. But there are lots of people, anti-theists especially, who genuinely believe that cults can only be a cult if they're religious. And I kept seeing this over and over again when I went after a very prominent, I'm not sure if it still exists in the capacity it exists back then, but a very secular, anti-theistic cult. And I kept seeing this over and over again by apologists of this cult by saying that, well, it can't be a cult, Jim, because it's explicitly anti-theist. It's explicitly atheist. Now, if you want to go into some of those videos that I posted and go and find some of those people, you can go ahead and talk to them and try to convince them that they're wrong. But these people definitely do exist. I encountered them frequently. And in fact, I was a big proponent of this idea back in the day. So, yeah, it's just so fucking absurd. Like, this is why I don't subscribe to this channel, because this is the constant thing that he does a lot of the times, is that he always tries to assume that people, when they use absolutist terms, that they're being absolute, even when they're not using absolutist terms. And the other thing that he constantly does throughout the same thing is he tries to, like, associate people, across ideological spectrums just because they share a similar or identical claim to something, or they have, like, some similar view. Like, there's things that, like one or two things that I agree with feminists about. Most of the things I don't agree with, but there's a couple of things that I definitely agree with them. Does that make me a feminist? Well, according to Nightmare Fuel, that would. That's the kind of bullshit that you can expect from Nightmare Fuel. This will be my last response to him, because I don't think he's intellectually honest. He's definitely not intellectually charitable. He's obtuse, and he's a complete fucking waste of time. And I'm just getting really tired of this kind of just this bullshit. I don't need this bullshit in my life. So anyways, I'll talk to you guys later. And yes, hail Satan. Christians, I'm the good guy. Hail Satan. Fucking moron.